Hey, welcome to the channel. I've owned my Gladiator for a little over a year now. I've been spending that time wheeling here in the Colorado mountains and building it out. I just wanted to take a few minutes to walk you through my build so far and talk about why I made some of the choices I made. I decided to go with a Gladiator because I wanted the utility of a truck bed, but the ability to still get out there and explore, and I have not been disappointed. I went with the base model Sport with a max tow package. I decided to go with the base model so I could build it out to my particular needs and taste. I didn't want to pay for things I was just going to have to replace or didn't need. It doesn't have lockers like the Rubicon. My plan was to get at least rear lockers this year, but after spending the last year wheeling here in Colorado and even going out into Moab, I've never gotten close to getting stuck. I've learned that the Jeep is very capable even in its base model. So now lockers have gone to, you know, a must to a wait and see, at least for me personally. I found that I have quality tires that I air down. I disconnect the front sway bar. I put it in the four low, pick a good line, and it can just kind of crawl through anything, even without the lockers. So maybe as I try maybe more adventurous trails, I might need them. But I built this not to be a rock crawler, and I'm not even an overlander, so it's not built with that into consideration either. I basically do out and back trails and long weekend camping, so it's a daily driver. So I didn't want to do anything to it that's going to compromise it. I just wanted it to be a nice, well-balanced vehicle, and I'm really happy with how the build has been going. So I'll start at the front. I went with the Quadratec steel stubby bumper. In there is the Smitty built synthetic line winch. For the tires, I went with 35-inch Yokohama Geolander Mud Terrain G003s, and I've been extremely happy with them. For the suspension, I went with the JKS 3.5-inch lift kit. Personally, I like the 35-inch tires with the 3.5-inch lift. I think it just looks really good. Underneath, I have ARB diff covers in the front and the rear, and a Falcon steering stabilizer. For light, I have the Rough Country hood light bar. I was concerned about getting a hood light bar as far as, you know, light reflecting off of the hood, but I haven't had too many problems. The one time where it was bad is there was snow on the hood, and when it hit that white snow, that did reflect pretty bad, but ordinarily it's not a problem. And I like how this light bar kind of sits back and low, so it's not in the way. I think it looks really good. I also installed the Mopar snorkel. You know, a lot of people think about water, but here it's just a dry place, so that way you get that cleaner air that's up higher. And we do have, you know, some water crossings, and from late spring to early summer when the snow is melting, the streams can get high. So it's nice to know that I can keep on going and not have to worry about water getting into the intake. And I'm also going to be extending the axle breather line, so I don't have to worry about that. As far as side protection goes, I did the DV8 rock sliders. I just really liked the look of those. I went with a basic roll-up tonneau cover to keep the rain, the snow, and the dust out of there, and it does a good job. Let me roll that back and I'll show you what I did in the truck bed. It's not a huge bed, so I've been trying to keep the main area as open as possible. So what I did is installed the JCR MOLLE panel on the side, and also up there at the front of the bed. Here, this is a swing case, so it sits nice and flush against the side. But if you need to get in there, all you do is pull the handle and then it swings out. So that way you can have easy access to whatever you keep in there. I myself have a recovery gear in there. And then when you're done with it, it just swings back in and is secured to the side of the bed. And there's also a place where you can put a padlock to keep somebody from lifting it out. Now to show you a few things I did on the inside, mostly to keep things organized. So up here I have a Bartek visor cover with MOLLE panels. So I have an air deflator, and up here I got a strap cutter and glass breaker. Got it for both sides. Also here I have a JCR MOLLE panel, slot for the driver and passenger side. So here I have a flashlight and a multi-tool in there.
One thing that I don't like about the Gladiator is just a lack of secure storage space. You know, the center console does lock, but I find myself wanting a little extra security for some things. So you pull that up, and I installed a safe in there.
Multiple handles. Another storage option for all the gear that you need. Here, this is also from Bartek. It is Velcro MOLLE panels, and it comes in a strip, and you can cut the fit in the back.
This is my build so far, but I have a lot more planned. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification button to follow along with the build.